Hello learners, my name is Dr. Priya Mahajan and our today's session is on economic planning. In this session, we will cover economic planning, meaning of economic planning, 12 5-year plan, objective of each 5-year plan and how 5-year plan has been finally replaced by Niti Aayog. So before I proceed towards the meaning of economic planning, I want to give you some background information about India's economic system and how plannings have been started in India. India got independence in 1947, and after independence, our leaders were very much concerned about India's economic growth and development. And they also have to decide the type of economic system suitable for the nation. Our Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was in favor of socialist economic system. Learners, socialist economic system is the system which is controlled and regulated by the government so as to ensure the equal welfare and equal opportunity for all the people of the country. But other leaders were not in favor of this. So after much debate and discussion, finally, mixed economic system with planning as their development strategies has been finalized in the country. Planning Commission was set up in 1950 with the Prime Minister of India as its chairperson. Planning Commission was responsible for formulating 5-year plans and other development functions. Finally, from 1951 onwards, 5-year plans has been started in India. Next is the meaning of economic planning. What is economic planning? Economic planning is to utilize the available resources. Resources means capital, labor, natural resources. So these are the resources and use them more effectively to achieve the predefined objectives, the objectives which were set for that particular time of period. So to achieve these objectives during the given period of time. Next is the goals of 5-year plan. All 5-year plans, they have some basic goals. That is growth, modernization, self-reliance, equity. Growth, it refers to increasing the country's capacity to produce the output of goods and services within the country. So example of growth is increasing GDP. GDP stands for gross domestic product. It means the market price of goods and services produced in the country during a given particular period of time. So increase in GDP is a symbol of growth of a nation. Next is the modernization. Use of new technology to increase the production of goods and services. But modernization doesn't refer only the use of new technology, but also to change in social outlook, such as the recognition that women should have the same right as men. Next is self-reliance. Self-reliance means standing on one's own leg, and dependence on foreign aid should be as minimum as possible. The first 7 5-year plans gave importance to self-reliance, which means avoiding imports of those goods which could be produced in country itself. Next is equity. Every Indian should be able to meet his or her basic needs, such as food, a decent house, education, and health care. And inequality in the distribution of wealth should be reduced. So it means the equal opportunity for all the people of the country. Next is the types of economic system. So socialist, there are three types of economic system: socialist economic system, capitalist economic system, and mixed economic system. Socialist economic system, as I told you earlier, that the system is the system which is controlled and regulated by the government. Capitalist economic system is the system where the private entrepreneurs, they have control over the economy. And mixed economic system is the system where both government and private entrepreneurs play equal role in the growth and development of the nation. So learner, this is all about the introduction. Next we will discuss the different 5-year plans. So first is the So start with the first 5-year plan, and its duration was for the period of 1951 to 1956 under the leadership of Jawaharlal Nehru. Objectives of this plan was the development of primary sector, rural development, price stability, power and transport. Many irrigation projects initiated during this span of period, like Bhakra, Hirakud, Meteor Dam and Damodar Valley Dams. 5 IITs were started as major technical institutions during this duration. UGC was also set up to strengthen the higher education in India. Contract was signed to start 5 steel plants. The target growth rate fixed for this time period for this plan was 2.1%, and actual achieved growth rate was 3.6%. So this first 5-year plan was a highly successful plan. Next is the second 5-year plan, and it was made for the duration of 1956 to 61 under the leadership of Jawaharlal Nehru. This plan focused on development of public sector and rapid industrialization. During this span of period, hydroelectric power project and 5 steel plants at Bhilai, Durgapur and Rourkela was established with the help of Russia, Britain and West Germany respectively. Railway lines were added in Northeast. Tata Institute of Fundamental Research was also established during this time period. The target growth rate fixed was 4.5%, and actual achieved growth rate was 4.27%. So this second 5-year plan was a decent successful plan. Next is the third 5-year plan. Third 5-year plan was made for the duration of 1961 to 1966 under the leadership of Jawaharlal Nehru. This plan focused on agriculture and improvement in wheat production to make India self-reliant and self-generating economy. This plan was a complete failure in reaching the target because some unforeseen events happened during this span of period. Like Indo-China War happened in 1962, then Indo-Pak War in 1965, and there was a severe drought in 1965-66. So this plan was a failure. You can see that the target growth rate fixed was 5.6% and actual achieved growth rate was only 2.4%. Next come the plan holidays. So due to the weak financial situation as well as the low morale after the defeat by China, the government decided to go for an annual plan. They named it a period of plan holidays. That is, the planning was on a holiday. During this plan, annual plans were made and equal priority was given to agriculture, its allied sectors, and the industry sector. Next comes fourth 5-year plan, and its duration was from 1969 to 1974 under the leadership of Indira Gandhi. Objective of this plan was growth with stability and progressive achievement of self-reliance. During this plan, the slogan of Garibi Hatao is given in the 1971 elections by Indira Gandhi. During this span of period, 14 major banks were nationalized. Green Revolution advanced agriculture in India. Indo-Pak War was also happened in 1971. But the target growth rate fixed for this plan was 5.6% and actual achieved growth rate was 3.3%. So this plan was also a failure, was not very successful. Next comes the fifth 5-year plan, and its duration was from 1974 to 1978. Objectives of this plan was increasing of employment level, reducing poverty, and attaining self-reliance. 20-point program launched during this period. The government changed during this period, and first non-Congress government took over in 1977 with Morarji Desai swearing in as first Janata Party Prime Minister of India on 24th March 1977. The fifth plan was terminated by Janata Party government in 1978, and they launched their own sixth 5-year plan for the period of 1978 to 83. The target growth rate fixed was 4.4% and actual growth rate achieved was 4.8%. Then rolling plan. This sixth plan, 1978 to 1983, which was fixed by the Janata Party, was again rejected by Indian National Congress government in 1980. When Congress government came in 1980, came in power in 1980, they rejected the 6-5-year plan that was decided by the Janata Party government, and they launched their new 6-5-year plan, and it was for the duration of 1980 to 1985. Then 6-5-year plan and duration was 1980 to 1985 under the leadership of Indira Gandhi. The basic objective of this plan was poverty eradication and technological self-reliance. The Indian National Highway System was introduced first time and many roads were widened to accommodate the increasing traffic. Tourism also expanded during this span of period. Family planning was implemented first time in India. Sixth plan also marked the beginning of economic liberalization. The target growth rate fixed was 5.2% and actual growth rate achieved was 5.7%. So this plan was a great success. Then comes the 7th 5-year plan, and its duration was from 1985 to 1990 under the leadership of Rajiv Gandhi. The objectives of this plan include the establishment of self-sufficient economy and opportunities for productive employment. In the first 6 5-year plans, more importance was given to the public sector than private sector. It is from the 7th 5-year plan onwards, private sector got the priority over public sector for the economic development of the country. The Jawahar Rozgar Yojana was launched in 1989 with the motive to create wage employment for the rural poor. The target growth rate fixed was 5% and actual growth rate was 6.01%. Then planning holidays for the duration of 1990 to 1992. The 8th plan, whose term would have been 1992 to 1995, couldn't take off due to the fast changing political situation at the center, and the year 1991 and 1992 were terminated as annual plans. The 8th plan was finally formulated for the period of 1992 to 1997. Then the 8th 5-year plan, and its duration was 92 to 97 under the leadership of P.V. Narasimha Rao. In this plan, the top priority was given to the development of human resources, that is employment, education, and public health. During this time, the country was going through a severe economic crisis, and the government initiated fiscal reform, or you can say the economic reforms, to provide a new dynamism to the economy. The target growth rate fixed was 5.6%, and actual growth rate achieved was 6.8%. Next comes the 9th 5-year plan. Its duration was from 1907 to 2002, and Atal Bihari Vajpayee was Prime Minister during this period. Objective of this plan was growth with social justice and equality. Target growth rate fixed was 7.1%, and actual growth rate achieved was 6.8%. Then comes the 10th 5-year plan, and its duration was from 2002 to 2007 under the leadership of Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Manmohan Singh. Objectives were, this plan aims to double the per capita income of India in the next 10 years. It aims to reduce the poverty ratio 15% by 2012, increase in literacy rate to 75%, reduction in infant mortality rate to 45 per 1,000 birth by 2007 and to 28 by 2012. Learners, infant mortality rate means the number of deaths per 1000 births under the age of 1 year. Learners, infant mortality rate means the number of deaths per 1000 live births of children under 1 year of age. Reduction in maternal mortality rate to 2 per 1000 live births by 2007 and to 1 by 2012. The total target, the target growth rate fixed was 8% and actual growth rate achieved was 7.2%. Next comes the 11th five-year plan. Its duration was from 2007 to 2012 under the leadership of Manmohan Singh. The main objective was faster and inclusive growth. And there are some various aims of this. There are various objectives of this plan. First one is the rapid growth, then increase of employment. So Manrega was promoted during this plan. Then in education, 8 new IITs, 7 new IIMs, and 10 new NITs have been started. Free and compulsory elementary education for the children between the age group of 6 to 14 years through Sarv Siksha Abhiyan was also started during this plan. Government makes sure that at least 33% of all direct and indirect beneficiaries of all government schemes are women and girl children. The target growth rate was 8.1% and actual growth rate achieved was 7.9%. Then comes the 12th five-year plan. Its duration was from 2012 to 2017 under the leadership of Manmohan Singh. Objective was faster, more inclusive and sustainable growth. Broader objectives are developing the capacity of growth, developing skills and greater generation of employment, poverty alleviation and managing environment. But in 2014, when NDA government came into existence under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, the 65-year-old planning commission has been dissolved, and on 1st January 2015, Niti Aayog was established. Niti Aayog is established as the government's think tank and to provide strategic and technical advice on policy matters. The full form of Niti Aayog is National Institution for Transforming India, and meaning is Niti means policy or ethics, Aayog means commission. So Niti Aayog is policy commission. So how Niti Aayog is different from the planning commission? First difference is Niti Aayog fosters cooperative federalism. Cooperative federalism denotes two-way relationship between the center and state government in matters related to economic policy and development. Niti Aayog has basically bottom-up approach. So in Niti Aayog, states have the equal involvement in the preparation of any plans. I mean, states, prime minister, state chief ministers, they also play an equal role. They can also give their suggestion while formulating the policies. But in planning commission formulating plan and ask state to implement the policy, whether they agree with this or not. So in planning commission, there was top down approach. In planning commission, states don't have such involvement. It's all decided by the planning commission, and they just ask state to implement the policies, whether they agree or not. Next is the Niti Aayog doesn't have the power to allocate fund, but can only make recommendations. Funding part is decided by the finance minister. But in planning commission, they had the power to allocate fund. Niti Aayog cannot impose policies that state government to follow. States were bound to implement the policy decided by the planning commission. So this is all about the difference between the planning commission and Niti Aayog. So this is the end of an era. Niti Aayog's basic job was to formulate the development blueprint, to create a dashboard for constant monitoring, evaluating and review, and to fix the outcome targets for all major schemes of infrastructure and social sectors. So this is all about the Niti Aayog and how Niti Aayog finally Niti Aayog replaced the 65-year-old Planning Commission. And this is learners. This is all about the planning 5-year plans and then how 5-year plans have been finally dissolved and replaced by Niti Aayog. So thank you, learners.